Many people's views of wild animals come from the pages of books they discovered early in life. Besides Durrell, there was another author writing at this time whose books influenced millions. Gavin Maxwell became world famous for his semi-autobiographical book Ring of Bright Water. Published in 1960, it told the story of his adventures living with a wild otter. It would later be made into a film, once again starring Virginia McKenna.
Ring of Bright Water was complex. Written by a complex man who had many dark periods in his life. And not all the stories of the otters are that joyful. And yet, it is this joyfulness, it's the rapport that he had with his animals, the affection he felt for them, his extraordinary gift of description of nature, the magic of his creative writing. It's all about involving us, isn't it? And allowing us to reach out and experience the things with the writer. It's gathering us in so that we share these experiences. And he was a master of that.
He became for me the central figure among the host of wild creatures with which I was surrounded. The waterfall, the burn, the white beaches and the islands. His form became the familiar foreground to them all. Or perhaps foreground is not the right word, for at Camus Fenner he seems so absolute a part of his surroundings that I wondered how they could ever have seemed to me complete before his arrival.
I think it was his ability to capture not just a sense of place and of this sort of seemingly idyllic lifestyle, but it was the personal connection with basically wild animals. That idea that he could capture so lyrically that relationship between man and beast was something that I found hugely attractive.
I think Ring of Bright Water was a component of the way that we started to think about wild animals differently, because it was a personal relationship, like it was with the Adamsons and Elsa, it was Gavin with Midge. And the possibility that these extraordinary relationships can happen.
I think what's crucial about these books, the Gerald Durrell, the Gavin Maxwell, is that they appeal to people who, of course, don't live in the countryside. They represent a kind of escapism, back to the land, back to the vanished England of hedgerows and otters and all of this kind of thing. They conjure up a world that most people, of course, wouldn't encounter in their daily lives.